I need help with calculus.
What do you want?
I need to take the limit.
No.
Please.
Come on in. What's the deal? What's your problem?
I don't know how to do this.
Stupid kids these days can't do simple problems.
It's 0/0.
That's called the indeterminate form. Give me the pen. So what the problem is here is you need to use L'Hopital's rule, which is when you have an indeterminate form that gives you 0/0 or infinity over infinity, and you have to take the derivative of the top and the bottom so you can solve the limit. So here's what you do. You have to write the LR sometimes. You have to write that to get the full understanding of the topic. So, limit, x approaches 0. Derivative of x, what's the derivative of x?
1.
It's perfect. What's the derivative of sine of x?
Cosine of x.
Now you plug it in, you get 1. That's your limit. That's L'Hopital's rule.
Awesome.
Don't come to me with this crap again.
Yes, sir.
Alright, so I solved the easy problem for you.
Is that Miss Frederickson? She's such a pretty picture.
What's your name? What's your name?
Russell.
Russell. My wife is now dead. It's a very sad story for a different time, but in the past, she always wanted the derivative. Oh. Hey, Russell, don't touch my... Hey Russell, stay away from that. That's a lever that launches the house. Somewhere in South America. It was where Ellie wanted to go when she was younger, but we're forced to go there now. Much earlier than I wanted to happen. I'm gonna have to pull out the world map.
Why is there a map in your shirt?
Russell, don't ask questions. That's a silly question. Shouldn't be asked.
So okay. We're gonna have to go from here to here like this, right?
Russell, that would be displacement. What we're looking for here is distance. We can't just go through these obstacles here. We have to find the total distance around them, which is a much different value than just going straight.
But how do we find distance?
What we're going to have to do, well, since it's more complex than just a simple plain old line, we're going to have to find the arc length. All right, Russell, arc length. Let's do this. Can't believe I have to show you this. It's really easy. All right, so for arc length, the formula for arc length is the length equals the integral. That's an integral, Russell. From A to B of the square root, that's a square root sign, Russell, of 1 plus the derivative of the function, these are brackets, squared. Don't forget the dx, because that's like the other part. It's like, imagine this is like a parentheses thing, okay? Dx. So now, we've got ourselves a good looking sine function. So we plug this into the formula. Length equals our bounds, so we're here, to Paradise Falls. Those are our bounds. The square root sign. 1
plus the derivative of sine of x is cosine of x, okay? So we plug that in. Cosine of x squared dx. That's your arc length. All right, Russell, that does it for arc length. Arc length is an extremely easy thing to do, and if you don't get this, you're stupid. Did you understand it all?
What's a sine function, Mr. Fredrickson?
Oh, Russell, you're killing me. You're killing me. Well, if we look over here, the sine function, this is a basic sinusoidal function, which is one of the transcendental functions that you'll come across a lot in the math world. But, you know, before I go into how the sine function works, I want to ask you, because this will make it much easier, do you know what a Taylor polynomial is? Because, yeah.
Of course I do. Does it look like I'm an AB?
It kind of does. Well, Russell, that impresses me a little bit, that you know what a Taylor polynomial is. So basically, to work out what a sine function is, we have to break it down into its Taylor polynomial, which you should have memorized, because it's going to be on a very important test later on in your life. So here's your sine of x. Now basically what the Taylor polynomial is, well, one of the major strengths of the Taylor polynomial is that it allows you to convert complicated transcendental functions that are insanely hard to deal with, like this sine of x. It's a really tough concept to understand here. And it lets you convert them into polynomials. So basically, this will equal x minus x cubed over 3 factorial plus x to the 5th over 5 factorial minus x to the 7th over 7 factorial. And it goes on and on like that.
What about the general term, Mr. Fredrickson?
What did you say to me?
What about the general term, Mr. Fredrickson?
Russell, what about the general term? What about the general? It's perfect. All right. What's the general term?
It's negative 1 to the n. On top, Mr. Fredrickson. On top.
That's not a fraction, Russell. Don't forget about it.
times x to the 2n plus 1. 2n minus 1. God, Mr. Fredrickson.
Russell, that's your fault.
Over 2n minus 1 factorial.
Parentheses?
Yes, Mr. Fredrickson.
Okay, Russell, okay.
I hope that's right.
Whoa. Russell, we're falling. Let's calculate the acceleration real quick. We seem to be accelerating at a rate of x cubed plus 3x plus 4. Plus 4. That's our acceleration function.
How'd you find that acceleration?
Russell, don't ask me questions. Why do I have to go over this every time? Just don't ask me questions. I know what I'm doing. This is my house.
Okay, Mr. Fredrickson. But how do we find the velocity from that?
Well, that's what we're about to do. We have to integrate the acceleration function to get the velocity. All right, so Russell, we got our acceleration function, which was the x cubed plus 3x plus 4. To get velocity, we have to go up a level, which means we're going to have to integrate the acceleration. Are you
DT
with me?
DT right, Mr. Fredrickson.
It's DX.
Yes.
It's DX. Russell, not DT.
DX.
Because this is like a parentheses. This is one, this is the other. One isn't complete without the other one. So we have our DX, we have our integral, now we just plug it in. Alright, our integral of x cubed plus 3x plus 4 dx. Russell. Alright, so we got our 1 over 4, because you got to raise it to 1 power and then put it over and then stuff like that. So 1 over 4 plus, alright, let's raise it to 1 power. That would be squared, so 3 halves x squared plus 4x. It's a bracket. And that's our integral. That's, we can't be missing anything. That should be it.
Alright, Russell, we're falling! Russell! Where are we?
This is looking Paradise Falls to me.
It's not.
What should we do? Where are we, man?
I don't know. What's that?
What the heck?
Oh, it's a dog. Don't touch me. Don't.
It just talked.
You can talk?
The dog can talk.
It's the collar. Of course I can talk.
Oh my god.
What are you guys even doing here?
It's a talking dog. I don't know.
What are you doing? You forgot the plus C. That's why we landed in the wrong place.
Wait, whoa.
Do you even do calculus?
Are you sure? Wait, why don't,
bounds on the integral?
No.
There's a plus C then.
Russell, what the heck,
there
man?
Has to be...
Russell.
There has to be a plus C.
What's the plus C? What
is it? It's the constant of integration. Don't you understand?
We forgot the plus C, Russell. Never forget the plus C.
What was that?
What the?
It's a bird. I think
what the heck?
I think I'll name it Kevin.
We need to keep Kevin quiet for a little bit.
Shut up, Kevin.
Paradise Falls is supposed to be right here, but there's a.
Something's wrong. Building right there for Paradise Falls.
It looks extremely dangerous. It's better be good. Alright, that's enough.
Hello, I've been expecting you. My name is Muntz.
Muntz?
Nice to meet you.
The Muntz?
Yes, the Muntz.
Wow, you've been my idol.
Who is this? I've been looking for this bird.
Oh, this is...
For 50 years.
This is, we found him just randomly walking around. We got lost here. We were
aren't you,
kind
aren't
of
you
calls,
amazed by how ugly this bird is?
I wouldn't call it that.
You wouldn't call this, look at this. Look how ugly it is.
Would you call that ugly?
Yeah.
But is this a special kind of bird?
It's the ugliest bird known to man.
Is it rare? Is it
ugliest thing on the planet, actually. I just wanna.
Is that why it's so valuable?
It's not valuable. But it's super rare.
It's rare.
Rare and ugly.
And you're trying to capture it.
I wanna kill it.
But why?
So I can stuff it and put it in my museum.
You can't kill Kevin!
What's the integral of sine?
Negative cosine.
You forgot the plus C. Oh.